Body and soul, I'm giving. are gathered together here in the sight of God and in his presence of these witnesses to join together this man and this woman in holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate instituted by God in a time of man's innocence, signifying unto the mystic union which between Christ and his church. It is commended of St. Paul to be honorable among all men, therefore not by any to be entered unto or taken in hand unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, advisedly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate, these persons come to join. Therefore, if any can show any just cause why they may not be lawfully joined together, let them now speak, or hereafter forever hold their peace. Who giveth this woman away?
Mercy, no mercy, I
Dante and Terry, mm-hmm. I require charge you both, as you will answer at the dreadful day of judgment, when the secret of all hearts shall be disclosed, that if either of you know any reason as to why you may not be lawfully joined together in matrimony, you do now confess it, for ye were assured that so many as are coupled together otherwise than God's word shall allow are not joined together by God, neither is their matrimony lawful. Terry, wilt thou have this woman to be thy wedded wife, to live together after God's ordinance and holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping thee only unto her, so as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Shantae, wilt thou have this man to be thy wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou submit unto him, serve him, love him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keeping thee only unto him as long as you both shall live? If so, say, I do.
I do.
This is it. Ain't no turning back. You was mine.
At this time, I have the rings. May these rings be an emblem to remind you both of the vows that you have mutually pledged. May it circle remind you that you are united in one common bond that is enduring. Therefore, may your faith in each other be lasting and unperishable as these rings. Repeat after me. With this ring. I thee wed. And with all my worldly goods. I thee endow. In the name of the Father. The Son. And the Holy Ghost. Hold your hand out. Repeat after me. With this ring.
Look at me.
I thee wed. And with all my worldly goods. I thee endow. In the name of the Father. The Son. And the Holy Ghost. Hold hands. At this time, let us pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, we come before you this day, O God, to say thank you for all that you have done. We thank you, Lord God, for bringing this couple together. Lord God, we ask that you be with them in the good times, as well as the bad. We ask that you sanctify them, Lord God, that their union shall grow, O God, that they shall flourish, O God, and that they shall serve you in all that they do, keeping you, O God, first in their lives. We ask that you bless this couple and in the union that they have come to join. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the precious Holy Ghost. Amen. Those who God has joined together, let no man put asunder. At this time, we will assemble the unity cross. At this time, we will assemble the unity cross. The unity cross is a wedding covenant. It's a lasting reminder of the bride and the groom of who they are. As you see, I have a wooden cross, empty, solid, but yet it's still empty. The cross is not complete without the woman. He might be strong, he might be bold, and he might be courageous, but yet he is not complete. So at this time, he will place his cross representing who he is in the peg. The centerpiece represents the woman in all her beauty and all her meekness. It shines, but it is not complete because it does not have anything to hold her together. So the cross represents what holds the family together. And the woman needs the man as the man needs the woman. So at this time, she will put the beauty of who she is that completes the man into his cross. This signifies that now they are together, but yet they are still not complete. Because without God, without the Son, and without the Holy Ghost, the marriage is not complete. Because God is their strength. Jesus is their Savior, and the Holy Spirit is what leads them and guides them along the journey. And without these three, the marriage will be rocky, the marriage will be difficult. But if they put these three on their side, they will be complete, and they will be able to do all things through Christ who strengthens them. So at this time, they will put one peg in each of the sides. The two ball and pegs represents the Son and the Holy Spirit, who are always by them their side. The top peg represents the Father, who completes the cross. And now they are complete. And at this time, I give unto you, Shantae, and unto Terry, a stroll of your vows, as though you will have difficult times, and sometimes you might think about giving up. You are to reach into this drawer and remind yourself of the commitment this day that you have made unto each other, and to remind you of who you are and the commitment that you have made unto God. May it keep your marriage strong, and at peace. May you put it in the box at this time. And any time you need it, open it and read the vows that you have made together. At this time, we're going to have you to step over to the candles, to extinguish the candles to unify that now they become as one. You walk beside her. This time, you may blow out the candles together. You may come back at this time. This time, grab a hand and bring her over. There you go. Okay. Now, you hold up. You step up. There you go. For as much as Terry Jeter and Shantae Nash have consented together in holy wedlock, hereunto have pledged their love each to the other, have declared the same by joining hands in the county of Cabarrus in the state of North Carolina, I, Reverend Kelly Stinson, on the day of the month of August 2018 AD, declare you are now husband and wife in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. At this time, you may kiss your bride. Brothers and sisters, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Terry Jeter.
I gave you.